Thank you for the introduction. Okay, nice to meet you all. I'm Shiho Maeshima from the Graduate School of Arts and Sciences, University of Tokyo. Okay, let me share the slides with you. Can you see? Okay. And my specialty is the history of comparative publishing and media history. In this presentation today, I'd like to discuss why you should study at the University of Tokyo and what the University of Tokyo has to offer. First, I would like to talk about the history of the University of Tokyo. The University of Tokyo is a public research university and was established in 1877. It was the first of the imperial universities in Japan. The university has 10 faculties and 15 graduate schools. About 25% of Japan's prime ministers are graduates from the University of Tokyo. And 5 graduates have become astronauts. The university has 5 campuses, but there are 2 main ones. One is Hongo, where the headquarter is located, which is close to Asakusa and Akihabara. Another is Komaba, where all the first and second year students at the University of Tokyo study, which is close to Shibuya and Shinjuku. The 2 campuses enjoy great central locations, meaning that students can easily enjoy downtown Tokyo. Oh, sorry. Okay. You can see the pictures from the downtown Tokyo. All of them are very close to the campus. The University of Tokyo is currently ranked 24th in the QS World History University rankings, having fallen in recent years due to its very low international students ratio. Therefore, we are working hard to encourage international students like you from all over the world to come and experience what we have to offer and in turn help us increase diversity across the university. UTOKYO is a public institution and charges the same fees to all students, whether undergraduates or graduates, and whether they are home or international students. This means when the rankings are weighted to include cost, our university jumps to number 3 in the list. In addition, Tokyo is second only to London as the city of choice for students worldwide. As I have explained, there are many reasons to choose the University of Tokyo: high level of education, research capabilities, social contribution, and inexpensive tuition fees, and bustling location. However, above all, I think the number one attraction is that the University of Tokyo, at the University of Tokyo, you can study a variety of academic fields. At the University of Tokyo, all students learn liberal arts during their first and second years and specialize in their third and fourth years. You may think that the purpose of studying at the university is to gain knowledge in a specialized field. And of course, focused expertise is important. However, it is essential to keep in mind that for a professional to exploit their expertise, specialized knowledge alone is not enough. What is needed is a broad education and the ability to weave specialties together, which is where liberal arts education comes in. For example, consider the challenge of dealing with COVID-19, a A vital aspect is the development of safe and effective vaccines. To develop a vaccine, we need knowledge of medicine, pharmacology, and chemistry. Next, we need the skills of engineers to mass produce them. When considering who to vaccinate in what order, discussions with professionals in philosophy, law, and social sciences are necessary. Since the development and the distribution of vaccines require cooperation and collaboration with various countries, it is also essential to have a sharp sense of cultural differences. An understanding of international affairs allows constructive discussions with countries and regions under complex circumstances. To disseminate the information about the nature of the disease and its preventive measures, moreover, we need knowledge of public health and the history of infectious diseases, as well as the technology and information sciences. Lessons can be learned from literature, arts, and history, where fears of new infections has led to various social problems. History teaches us that there are people panicking and attacking certain others, and also demonstrates some hints for ways to overcome such challenges. As you can see, each professional is not independent and needs to collaborate with experts from other disciplines to realize their expertise in the real world. At that time, it is essential to understand other specialists' interests, which may be different from our own, and use our imagination for their commitment. I believe that having an environment where you can use your imagination, for example, a campus where you can interact with people studying different specialties, will benefit you tremendously. Thank you very much for listening.
Thank you very much, Professor Maeshima.